Good morning, my name is Belén López Álvarez and I am the Health Desk Assistant for the ER en Transplantal. Today we are going to share with you our experience with the CPMS management. Last year, with the Connecting European Facility co-founding, we established the Transplantal Health Desk. The Health Desk has been providing training, support and monitoring for the two IT systems developed for the ERM members, the ECP and the CPMS. On this presentation, we are going to go more in detail on the activities carried out for the CPMS. The first activity is the training, and a strong effort has been made in order to ensure that all the ERN centers had the technical and legal requirements to use CPMS. For that reason, the first step on this training has been to approve the standardized consent form for the ERNs. We have contacted all the representatives of transplant health centers and we have started the approval process with the corresponding legal and ethical committee of each hospital. Some of these centers have made some modifications to this template in order to meet the local requirements of their hospitals. The health desk has support and follow up this process in order to solve any incidents. After some months, several months, all the centers have the consent form approved and they were ready to use the CPMS system. The second key point on this training has been the on-site training sessions. We have visited almost all the transplantile centers in order to provide them a face-to-face training on how to use the CPMS system. This training has been a little bit complex because we want it to be effective and we want this training to reach as many professionals as possible. We have invited all the experts of each centers that were involved in pediatric transplantation, but also other professionals that were interested on CPMS or that belong to any other ERN. The on-site training sessions consisted on two main parts. The first one, the presentation with the CPMS background, the objectives, and the virtual consultation workflow. The second part was the hands-on training, in which we create a CPMS panel with the experts. Finally, we take opportunity to create CPMS accounts for all the attendants of these sessions. Also, within this training, we have scheduled two CPMS workshops in order to help the users to get more familiar with the CPMS system. The first workshop, we review the technical features of the CPMS in order to help the users to get these technical skills to use the system. The second workshop had a more clinical approach and we discussed some clinical cases through the CPMS system. Both workshops took place during the Board of Members of Transplantal in these annual meetings. And this is important because we gather all the representatives of the networks in these workshops and we give a special space to the CPMS since within Transplantal the CPMS is a key activity and it has a very high priority. This has helped to have more commitment from the members and to be more active in the CPMS system. The second activity is the support. We have developed different support materials in order to help the users to use CPMS and ECP. We have created different user manuals for the different panel steps from creating a CPMS account to enroll a patient, create a CPMS panel, schedule a meeting, upload medical documents, etc. We have also recorded periodical webinars with CPMS demonstrations and with the new features of the CPMS released. We have also created some informative brochures for patients and professionals and some other materials like frequent asked questions and promotional videos. All these materials are concentrated in a dedicated webpage for CPMS and ECP. And we think this resource is very important for the users because they have available all the material and this support can be maintained over time. Another key point in this support has been the CPMS panel support. The executive committee, together with the healthcare working group, they have designed a strategy in order to support the CPMS panels. Within this strategy, we have done the selection of experts for each panel in order not to overload the same three experts all the time. It has been also very useful, the panel manager user, because we have been able to do the panel selection. We can also accept the invitations on behalf and move the panel forward. We have also developed a standardized model of support in order to define the adequate times for each panel stage and the actions to take if the panel is blocked. For example, in our case, it has been very useful the personalized email reminders with the actions to do for each panel member. Finally, all this strategy aims at preventing the panels to get stuck, and it also makes the discussion of the cases more fluid. Finally, just to highlight the support in the CPMS incidents, the local help desk has been the first line support for the CPMS users, and most of the problems and the incidents have been resolved locally, because they were most of them about the problems with the login or questions about the panels. Some other incidents were reported to the DigiSante because they could not be solved locally. And we have a very prompt response, and they were solved in a very short period of time, thanks to the IT team of the DigiSante. Finally, there has been other problems related with the system that could only be solved by the OpenApp developers. In our opinion, there has been a very good cooperation and coordination between these levels of support, and the users are very happy with this support. The final activity has been the monitoring. We have a follow-up and monitor the CPMS activity using the status report automatically generated by the DigiSante. That has been very useful in order to see the general activity of transplant child in comparison with the rest of the ERNs. We have also used the data automatically generated by the CPMS system in order to create monthly reports. We have also recorded some other indicators locally, for example, the number of experts per panel, the type of specialty of those experts, and the time spent in each panel stage. All these data and indicators have been used in order to create efficiency analysis. This analysis has helped us to identify the conflict points on the workflow and also some problems in the management in order to improve the way we train and support the members. Also, we have identify some points of improvement, for example, the time response in the assessment stage. Also, this analysis together with the user's feedback has given us some improvement proposals that can be resumed in three different points. The first one is to reduce the complexity of the CPMS system to make it more easy. The second one is to make the system less rigid, to make the discussion be more dynamic. And the third point is to improve the user experience and user interface to make CPMS more user-friendly. Also, we have divided the information by centers. This was very useful in order to identify the centers that are more committed to the CPMS and in order to encourage those who has less activity on the CPMS system. Finally, as a conclusion, we are going to give the key activities that for us have helped to increase the activity on this system. The first one is the face-to-face meetings for the training. The second one is to include this CPMS activity as a key activity in the network, to give it a high priority and to commit all the and to make the centers to be committed with the activity. Also to manage all the panels from the help desk and the coordination team in order to prevent those panels to get stuck. Also to send regular personalized email reminders for the experts, because we have seen that the automatically generated reminders from CPMS are not useful for the users. Finally, to monitor the activity and collect the user feedback. This is a very important point in order to identify the conflict points in the workflow and also in the management of the CPMS. With all this information, we give feedback to the DigiSante in order to keep improving the CPMS and make it more successful. Finally, the last slide is challenges for the near future. The first one is that we have less time and resources for this activity. We used to be 2 people dedicated for CPMS, and now we have more activities to get done and less people to be dedicated for CPMS. And we are afraid that this could affect the activity and the outcomes of the CPMS. Another challenge is that new members and new affiliated partners are joining the network, and that means more people to be trained and more people to give support and a heavier workload to the help desk. The third point is probably the most important one, is the experts' workload. They are always complaining that they don't have enough time for CPMS and they don't have time for extra activities. For that reason, we consider very important to involve hospital managers in this activity in CPMS, so they can include the CPMS as part of the clinical routine of the experts. Finally, to reduce the complexity of the system and make it more user-friendly, that probably is a reality in a short period of time, and keep working with the help desk, the DigiSante, and the Open App in order to make CPMS successful. Thank you very much for your attention.